Hello, Bea here, and welcome back to Environmental Science. Have you ever heard the phrase, the circle of life? What do you think that phrase means? Well, there are many different interpretations of this popular phrase, and one applies to today's lesson, how energy flows through an ecosystem. In this definition of the phrase, the circle of life, it describes how the flow of nutrients and energy through an ecosystem is cyclical, interconnected, and never-ending. We are going to look at this process in today's lesson. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to define a food chain and a food web, identify the different parts of a food chain and food web, discuss how energy flows in an ecosystem. My goodness, isn't it a gorgeous morning in the mountains? The sun is shining bright, and the grass and other plants are really soaking it all in. In an ecosystem, plants are considered producers. This is because they produce their own food through the process of photosynthesis. Oh, look! That grasshopper is adorable! He's just enjoying his breakfast of grass, so we won't bother him. Grasshoppers are herbivores, meaning they only eat plants, and are called primary consumers. In this case, the grasshopper is nibbling on the long grains of grass, getting nutrients from the plant. Oh no! That grasshopper better keep an eye out! It looks like that bird is hungry! We know that most birds are omnivores, eating both plants and animals. However, in situations like this, in which they eat insects such as grasshoppers, they are considered secondary consumers. Uh-oh, now we really need to be careful. I see a fox over there, and it looks like it is ready for its breakfast, and it's eyeing that bird. Foxes are also omnivores, eating mainly rodents, small birds, and other animals, as well as fruits and other plants. On this particular morning, though, the fox is going to hunt the bird for breakfast. In this situation, the fox is a tertiary consumer. The breakfast situation we just saw unfolding is an example of a food chain. A food chain is a one-way movement of energy through an ecosystem. In this example, the energy moved from the sun to the grass, to the grasshopper, then to the bird, and finally to the fox. Energy moves up through the consumption of food, both plants and animals. Think back to the fox in our food chain. As we mentioned, foxes are omnivores, meaning they eat plants and animals. In the food chain we discussed, the fox ate a bird, but often a fox will eat plants as well. Ecosystems are way more complicated than a food chain allows it to be described. Because of this, we use food webs to show the energy flow from producers up to consumers. Food webs show how multiple food chains intersect and will include all of the different energy pathways in an ecosystem. If you look carefully at this food web, you will see the food chain we discussed earlier, grass to grasshopper to bird to fox. However, there are multiple other food chains within this web. So far in our food web and food chain, we have left out one very important step, the decomposers. The role of the decomposers in an ecosystem is to break down the dead organic matter. This means that when plants and animals die, decomposers like worms, bacteria, and fungi have the important role of breaking it down so that the nutrients are not locked in a dead organism and can therefore complete the circle of life. We often forget about the decomposers, but their role is invaluable in the food webs of ecosystems. Let's go back to our food chain one more time, starting with the grass, then the grasshopper, birds, and finally the fox. I want you to take a moment and think about the populations of each of these species. Specifically, I want you to focus on the relationship between the organism's placement in the food chain and its population size. You should notice that as you move up the food chain, the population size decreases. This is because as you move up a food chain, there is less energy available. In fact, each energy level only passes on 10% of its energy to the next level. This is because 90% of the energy consumed by an organism is used by that organism to grow and survive, leaving only 10% of the energy it has consumed remaining when it dies. This 10% is passed on to whatever organism eats it. This lower energy availability means there are fewer organisms at that energy level because there is a limited amount of energy available to support them. This system is called an energy or trophic pyramid. As we went through the lesson today, we learned how energy moves through an ecosystem from the producers all the way to the tertiary consumers, then back to the producers through decomposers. This forms a cycle of nutrients and energy flow that helps keep an ecosystem healthy. This is our last lesson in our ecology unit. The next lesson will be a review and assessment of the topics covered in Unit 2. Until next time, remember, you're a force of nature, so keep sparking the changes that you want to see. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.